What's up, guys? Plus Two Soul here. So I'm sure you guys already saw the post on Facebook. We are going to be doing a Nisekoi waifu deck series here. We're going to be doing all the girls, Chitoge, Onodera, Tsugumi, and Marika, in that order. So basically, I had this Chitoge deck here. We're going to be doing this. Before I get into the deck profile, I want to talk about what we're going to do in this deck series. I decided to go pure is this character. So for example, this deck profile, it's all Chitoge. There's actually no Tsugumi, no Onodera, no Marika, etc. I decided, you know, like, yeah, of course, we're gonna, if you mix in different characters, the deck would have been a lot better, would run a lot smoother. It would have been the greatest thing ever. But I decided not to. I decided to go with a pure character deck. It was actually really hard because I couldn't figure out what cards to put in. I mean, yeah, there's not that many options, but still, it was like how many copies should I put in, kind of thing. But I finally made it, and it's basically not the greatest thing, but you know, it's what it is. But the Tsugumi, there are bonders in this set, and they actually bond with different characters. For example, Chitoge and Ono, and Tsugumi, they bond to each other, kind of thing. I decided not to put that in because I would have to run Tsugumi cards in order to run that bonder, so decided not to put that in. Other than that, the Onodera Rui deck, there's a possibility I might have to run Rui in that deck. I do want to go pure Onodera, which is possible. But Ludi does help a lot in the Onodera deck, so I might have to let that slide for me, because Ludi works very well with Onodera. But if I can just make a deck with Onodera purely, then I'll do that. But I might actually just make both Onodera deck and then Onodera Ludi deck. I might do that. But other than that, yeah, that's basically what I'm gonna be aiming for. So let's go ahead and start off with this Chitoge deck here. So this level 0 card, definitely a staple in any Nisekoi deck. The Suicider that runs. Now, this basically runs only to the center, or the middle center stage. And it's a runner. It helps you get to level 1 faster. It kills off any level 0 on your opponent's field. And basically, it's what you want in any deck. I think this card's effect is like very, very good. It's basically one of the best Suiciders in the game, definitely. In order for your opponent to kill it, they have to have a card in front of it and a card in the middle center stage, and basically like this. This is your opponent. They have to look like this. So if you're running, then you're gonna get killed anyways, kind of thing. So definitely a really, really good card. Yeah, I have different sleeves here. I actually took this from my main deck because I don't have extra Suiciders. These are expensive, man. So definitely a really good card. Next, we have the support here. Now, a lot of you guys are saying that the PR support Chitoge is really, really good. I actually think that card is whatever's. To me, price wise, I think that card is just like a 50-cent card because of the Sal card. The Asuna card is basically the same effect. But I honestly think there are better supports in the booster box itself. You really, really do not need that PR card, guys. It's just something that to show off to your friends or like other players, like, I got this card, guys, what up, kind of thing. So you don't need that PR card at all. This PR card, I'm not PR card, this support card here, actually, I don't think I should be running this at beginning of the game. I'm actually running this for late game. Why? But let's actually talk about the effect real quick. It's plus 500 to the characters in front of this. And then the second effect is basically you take one of your pendants in memory, put it into the waiting room, and then give one of your characters plus 1k and 1 soul. Now, why do you want to take out a pendant that you really need in memory into the waiting room? Now, the reason why I put this card in for ending game is because of the soul damage. Well, because like you want to attack for exact soul to win the game. You don't want to go over, you don't want to go less, kind of thing. So like, for example, if your opponent is at 3-7, if your opponent is at 3-5 and then you want to do exactly 2 damage, just take out one of your pendants, put it into the waiting room, give plus 1k one soul to one of your one soul characters and just attack for attack for game kind of thing. So that's why I actually put a lot of thought into it, and I thought this card would have been really good to end games. So definitely a really, really good card to end games. I actually was thinking about putting this card in my deck, my main deck, but like, I don't need this. But yeah, I actually think this card is really, really good if you think about it. And it's not that bad of a card at all. Definitely a great card to win games. Like, yeah, you can use it during, you know, the beginning, level zero to get that power. You won't be able to use the second effect, but still, I mean, really good. You don't want to take out the level, the pendants out at level one and two, because you actually kind of need them at level one and two because of a specific Chitoge cards. But definitely a good card to use at end game, because you're not going to need the pendants anyways at level three, because Chitoge doesn't really use the pendants at level three. Next, we have Vanilla Chitoge's, just to fill up the level zero slot. Next, we have this Chitoge here, definitely the best Chitoge level zero card, in my opinion. Or, I'm sorry, the second best beater level zero card, in my opinion. Suiciders, I think, is the best. But anyways, this is basically when you have one or less characters on the field. This gets plus 1k, and it gets character encore, so ditch a card from hand to the waiting room. Really, really good card. Helps. Basically, it's going to be on your field, a level 0 field, for a really long time. It's going to basically be your level 0 game, unless you have that Suicider on the field. Definitely a really, really good card. It's your beater, so definitely a card that you probably would run in your pure Chitoge build. Next, we have Brainstormer. Definitely the Mariko Brainstormer is a lot better, but like I said, we're going with a pure Chitoge build, so I decided to put this in. It is basically when your other characters gets reversed in battle, you get to give plus 1k to any of your characters for that turn. So basically, if this card gets reversed, you won't get the effect, but if another character gets reversed, plus 1k over here, over here, over here, kind of thing. And then the Brainstorm effect, basically if you mill 4, you get to basically give 2k to any of your characters for each climax you hit. Now, this is spammable, so you can pay out climaxes like this, you can thin out your deck, you can basically do the whole shenanigans that you should be doing with Brainstorm effects anyways. But definitely a really good Brainstorm in my opinion, but I still think the Marika is better. Next, we have the PR Chibi Chitoge. Now, this card is really, really good. More like all the Chibi PR cards are actually pretty good. They actually salvage the pendant card in waiting room and put it back into your hand. That's the reason why I run this. The first effect is basically gives plus 1k to the middle center stage. It's really good because it helps me buff out my level 2 cards that get buffed. It buffs out my level 1 cards that basically lack power, and etc. So definitely a really pretty good support, and then not only that, it helps me salvage the pendant when I need it in the waiting room, or when I really need it out of the waiting room. So this is basically my only salvage card for the pendant. I don't really have anything else to get it, so I either have to draw into the pendant card or salvage it with this kind of thing. So definitely this is the card I want in my hand, so I can get those pendants in my hand kind of thing. So definitely a really good card that you really need in a Chitoge deck build. Next, we have probably my favorite support in this set. It's the 1-0. I talked about this in my last Nisekoi video. Definitely a really, really good support. Plus 500 to all your characters, and if you have two or more pendants in memory, another 500 into the front, in front of this card. So definitely a really, really good support, guys. And I have mail. But anyways, definitely a really, really good support. This is definitely my favorite support in this set. You guys should be running this. This card is really, really good. Next, we have some level 1 cards. This is a 1045. Basically, it gets plus 2k if you have a pendant in memory. It becomes a 1065, basically somewhat of a vanilla. And then, obviously, if you have support, bigger. So, just there to be a beater. You know, zero cost. I need the stock kind of thing. Next is the 1-1 Chitoge. If you have two or more key characters on the field, plus 1k. Which is it becomes a 7k vanilla, and then it has character encore, so basically you can it stays on the field as long as you pay the cost of ditching a character into the waiting room. So a really, really good card. This is basically going to be your level 1 game, and maybe your level 2 game if you don't have your level 2 cards, but definitely this is going to be my level 1 game if I have it onto the field. Next we have this 1-0 Chitoge. This actually climax combos with a 2K1, this card right here. Basically, when this card comes from hand to stage, it gets plus 15, so it becomes a 6K, and if you give it 2K, obviously bigger, and then support, bigger as well. Then the climax combo, when you pay 2, basically, and we have this Koisuru Juliet on the field, you can pay the cost, which is 2 stock, and then if you do, you can basically sell... Oh, you can search your deck for a level 1 or lower key or weapon character and put it onto the stage and then shuffle anywhere onto the stage and then shuffle your deck. Now, I think this effect is actually really, really good. You can pay out climaxes from stock, obviously, but bringing out a level 1 character or lower from your deck and putting it anywhere onto the field is really, really good. Like, you can actually bring out supports like this because you're not it still gets the buff as long as the support's on the field. So, for example, the 1-0 support here, if you don't have this on in your back row, you can actually bring this out from the deck, put it in the back row, and then it gets the buff kind of thing. So, really, really good combo to do that. I think this card is really good. It's just the lack of power, and then obviously it's a 2K1 climax kind of thing. But definitely a really, really good card if you're running a pure Chitoge deck. I mean, in general, I think this card is really good. Next, we have the Pendant, obviously. This has Chitoge on it, so definitely something you want to run. Definitely you have to run in a pure Chitoge build. So, it just basically searches out a key character from your deck and then shuffle, then put in the memory kind of thing. So, definitely Pendant and Nisekoi are very, very important. It's basically the main engine of the deck, so you have to run Pendants, guys. If you don't, then your deck is basically screwed. I think the only character that doesn't need Pendants is that Tsukumi. So next we have level 2 cards, 2-1. It climax combos with a Wind Trigger. Now, personally, I'm not a big fan of sending cards back to the hand, but what this card does, you pay 2, and when this card attacks, you have the climax combo Nisemono Koi. You pay the cost. If you do, you get to send 2 characters from your opponent's stage and send it back to their hand. Now, like I said, I'm not a big fan of sending characters back to the hand because it gives your opponent more options. They have more hand size now. They can, if they have level 3 in hand, they can just heal again kind of thing. They can reuse effects and stuff like that. So definitely a card effect I really dislike, but I actually think this is actually the best way to go for a Chitoge build. There's like 3 different climax combos that she can do, but I think this is one of the best ones that you can do because you can deal more damage or you can do just send cards back to the hand to get rid of annoying cards that you can't kill, or just like they're super annoying, just get rid of them kind of thing. But definitely they can, the only downside about it is that you're giving your opponent more options, but you're also like helping yourself like dealing more damage, or you know, just getting rid of cards that are just super annoying kind of thing. If they can't pay for the stock after you send it back, then hey, good for you kind of thing. So second effect is Clock Encore. I don't think I'd be using that if I really need to. Like, clock encoring at level 2 is very, very bad because you actually kind of want to stay at level 2 before your opponent. I mean, you want to take your opponent to level 3 before you do, kind of thing. So, definitely something you don't want to really do at level 2. So, I'm personally not a big fan of clocking level 2 as well. So, but if you really need to, do it, kind of thing. But definitely something I don't want to really use. Next, we have this 2-1 Chitoge here. I actually would be running more of these, but I decided not to. It needed the space. But for each pendant in your memory, plus 1K. So if you have all 4, plus 4K. Support, buffer, and stuff, etc. So really, really strong card, but I decided not to put more than 2 because I personally think I wouldn't be staying at level 2 as long And I don't think, if for some reason, if I don't have Pendant in my memory, then, you know, this card is just like pretty useless in my hand or on the stage because it's super weak. But that's how I, you know, how I saw it. So if I, as long as I get Pendant in the memory before level 2, then this card is really, really good. If I don't, then this card is like, oh shoot, it's pretty weak, it's useless. But yeah, definitely something you should be running in a Chitoge deck. Next we have the counter. Now there actually aren't Chitoge counters other than this, so it kind of sucks that I can't use any 1-0 counters. But basically the counter is 25, and then the first effect, you pay an extra 2, so you pay a total 3 stock. If you do, you get to send one of your characters from your stage to the waiting room. Then you get to kill off a card that is higher, the level is higher than your opponent. So for example, level 3 is at level 2, you can kill off those level 3s. If they have a level 2 at level 1, kill off that level 2 kind of thing. So definitely a really good card to kill off some annoying cards on the field. But just use it wisely. Don't use it like, oh, you're level 3 on the field, kill that right away. Like, use it wisely, guys. Definitely something you should decide to run in a Chitoge deck. I actually was not going to run this, but I kind of needed some kind of counter, you know. I need something, so I decided to run that. Next, we have level 3s. Now, personally, I hate this card. This card is, like, probably one of the worst level 3 cards in this set. That's a level 3 Chitoge yellow. The first effect is basically that burn effect that I personally don't like. Basically, when this card is played from hand to stage or via change, it gains the effect and you only can use it once per turn. If this card's attack gets canceled, you can deal 1 damage. I personally hate that effect. If you're gonna attack, just go through. I really hate it when, like, my attack doesn't go through and they take 1 damage and they're left at 3-6 and you're like, I just needed 1 more damage kind of thing. I really hate that. I can attack with this first and attack with my other characters, but, you know, it's just like, ugh, I just needed 1 more damage. I really hate that feeling. I'm pretty sure most of you guys understand that. But, I have to do it because it's a level 3 Chitoge. I mean, it's really cool that Nisekoi has 2 level 3s for each female character, so that's really cool. Next, the Climax combo. I decided not to run the Climax combo because if I would have had 8 2K1s in my deck, and I don't want 8 2K1s. That's like boring, and then it's just like 2K1s is too much kind of thing. So, plus the Climax combo is not even that great. It's like check top 4, and then when this card attacks, check top 4. Pick a card from there, put it in the hand, then send the rest to the waiting room, and then this card gets plus 15 to the end of your opponent's turn. If the power was at least like 2, 3k, maybe 4, then, you know, it would have been a lot better, but it's only 15, and then, like, you're trying to set up for next turn, and there's a possibility that you might not even win. You might not even survive for next turn kind of thing. So, I don't really think this card's that great in first place, and it's a level 3 Chitoge, why not, kind of thing. I mean, I could use that first effect anyway, so whatevers. Next, we have the last character card in this deck, 3 level 3 Chitoge Reds. Definitely a really good card. Combos very well with the Marika, but obviously I cannot run the Marika in this set. But played from hand, it heals. And then the second effect is pay 1, rest 2 characters for the turn, it gets plus 2k. Falling ability, if this card reverses a card in front, put that on the top deck of your opponent's deck. Really, really good card. I like it. Really good. Combos very well with the Marika, like I said, but can't run the Marika. Ugh. But this is basically your end gamer. It helps you guarantee the next damage. So attack, if they're at 3-6, oh, I guarantee next damage, attack for 1. Yeah. Just pray that you don't trigger soul. But yeah, definitely that's basically all the characters in this set. Next, Climaxes, 4 tornadoes and then 4 2K1s. Like I said, I'm not running 2K ones. That's just way too much. I think this is the best way to go for a pure Chitoge build. But yeah, that's basically about it. Combos, really nothing much to talk about for combos. This is like play Chitoges, try to get pendants in memory. Stay that level 1. Bring out level 2 if you can. Level 3 game right there, kind of thing. And then if you can, try to end the game maybe with the support here. So yeah, that's basically about it. Thanks for watching, guys. Remember to subscribe to the video. Subscribe to the channel, like the video, comment down below, like our Facebook page. And also, I'm actually doing a giveaway for a Chitoge Nendoroid on my other blog, Kitakubu. The link will be down below as well, so check that out. I know you guys like Chitoge, so try to get that Nendoroid. Next, we're going to be doing Onodera, so look forward to that. Later, guys.